But in Matthew chapter 24 and verse 8, it says, all these are the beginnings of sorrows. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and ye shall be hated of all nations for my name's sake. And then shall many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. And many false prophets shall rise, and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved from this destruction that's being described. But look at this. And this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached unto all the world for a witness unto all nations, and then shall that end come. That gives you marching orders for what our last day's duties are, doesn't it? Preach the gospel. Preach the gospel. There's going to be people betraying brothers and sisters unto the death. There's going to be hatred within what used to be called love. There's going to be false prophets rising, deceiving many, and iniquity waxing cold. And our job is to take that gospel and preach it to all the nations.
Amen.
Then shall that end come. Okay? So there's our marching orders at these days. And this is what I've always pictured, and my wife and I have talked about this in description of the last days, is that we're marching forward with a Bible in hand, preaching the gospel as there's bombs and guns going off everywhere. We're seeing hell on earth. We're seeing iniquity abound. We're seeing rioting. And we're standing on a street corner and saying, repent and believe the gospel. It's faith alone. In Christ alone. Right? That's the last days Christian, okay? We're not hiding away, sheltering in place. Throw that new Canadian flag in the garbage. I don't know if you've seen it.
Yeah.
You replace the leaf with a house. Bunch of clowns.